Hey everyone, welcome back again. Elon Musk, the visionary CEO of SpaceX, recently elucidated the distinctive features of the latest version of the Starship, emphasizing its advancements over its predecessor. In a detailed post on the social media platform X, formerly Twitter, Musk delved into the enhancements of version 2 of the Starship. He pointed out that this iteration boasts a larger propellant capacity, reduced dry mass, and heightened reliability. Responding to a user's inquiry about the upcoming launch vehicle, Musk highlighted the pivotal changes that make the new version a significant leap forward. Moreover, Musk emphasized the Starship's primary goal of accommodating a substantial number of passengers on tens of thousands of flights. He underscored the imperative for the spacecraft to exhibit exceptional reliability over an extended period. Musk exuded confidence, stating unequivocally that the Starship will indeed meet and exceed these stringent reliability standards. In addressing potential setbacks, such as isolated engine failures, Musk shed light on the strategic decision to incorporate multiple engines. The Super Heavy booster, a crucial component of the Starship, boasts an impressive array of 33 engines, surpassing even the Soviet N1 first stage, which had 30 engines. Musk articulated that this abundance of engines is a deliberate measure to enhance the overall reliability of the Starship. The anticipation surrounding the unveiling of this new version escalated after Musk shared a photograph of Starships at Starbase, captioned with the enigmatic words, "The last of V1. SpaceX initially introduced the V1.0 prototype of the Starship in 2020, designed specifically for an orbit test flight. Despite previous iterations, the V1 prototype marked a significant milestone in the development of the Starship. SpaceX's Starship holds paramount importance in Musk's grand vision of facilitating human landings on both the Moon and Mars. The recent liftoff on November 18th marked the second iteration of the Starship, showcasing successful stage separation. However, the subsequent explosion of the booster and the loss of contact with SpaceX after reaching an altitude of nearly 150 kilometers underscored the challenges inherent in space exploration. While the test launch did not achieve its ultimate goal of a round-trip flight with a splashdown in the Pacific Ocean, it provided valuable insights for the ongoing refinement and improvement of the Starship. The European Space Agency, ESA, recently carried out an extensive firing test of a prototype Ariane 6 on November 23rd, marking a crucial step before confirming the date for its inaugural launch. At approximately 3:44 p.m. Eastern Time, the Vulcan 2.1 engine within the core stage of the Ariane 6 test model was ignited on the launch pad in Kourou, French Guiana. However, the initiation of the test was delayed by almost 45 minutes due to a temporary halt in the countdown at 2 minutes and 42 seconds. This pause was attributed to what the ESA referred to as a small anomaly in the transient threshold pressure. The scheduled test firing, replicating a complete burn of the core stage during an actual launch, was expected to last 470 seconds. Controllers confirmed a shutdown at the anticipated time, despite noticeable changes in the engine's performance in the final minute of the burn. ESA, in a subsequent statement, declared the Ariane 6 test a success, describing it as a 7-minute full firing rather than the initially advertised nearly 8 minutes. Joseph Aschbacher, the Director General of ESA, expressed his satisfaction, stating, "The teams from Ariane Group, Sinaz, and ESA have now run through every step of the rocket's flight without it leaving Earth." Ariane Group serves as the prime contractor for the rocket, while CNS is the French space agency. Aschbacher emphasized the significance of this milestone, underscoring the years of meticulous planning, designing, preparation, and hard work by some of Europe's finest space engineers. He added, "We are back on track towards resecuring Europe's autonomous access to space." ESA officials, including Aschbacher, indicated that this full-duration static fire test represents one of the final assessments before the agency officially announces the launch window for the first Ariane 6. Aschbacher, speaking during a press briefing on November 6th after the European Space Summit in Seville, Spain, noted, "Depending on the outcome of this test, afterwards, I will be in a position to announce a launch date for Ariane 6 for the inaugural flight." the upcoming hot-fire test of the Ariane 6 upper stage, designed to evaluate its performance under degraded conditions, is scheduled to take place at a facility in Germany in December. Martin Sion, chief executive of Ariane Group, outlined the remaining steps, including additional tests to demonstrate fault tolerance, shipping the flight hardware for the first launch to Kourou, and performing a launch system qualification review. However, he emphasized, Ariane 6 now has a core stage and an upper stage, which have undergone all testing necessary to be ready for the inaugural flight. The successful test marks a significant stride forward in securing Europe's independent access to space. Chinese space startup Landspace has recently revealed ambitious plans to pioneer a groundbreaking reusable stainless steel rocket, dubbed the Zhuque-3 or Vermilion Bird 3. This innovative two-stage launcher is set to revolutionize space travel by incorporating stainless propellant tanks and clusters of Tianke methane liquid oxygen propellant rocket engines. During a presentation at the Mingyu Lake Aerospace Information Industry International Ecosystem event in Chongqing, China, Landspace CEO Zhang Changwu outlined the key features of the Zhuque-3. The rocket boasts an impressive payload capacity of 20 metric tons to low Earth orbit, LEO, in its expendable state. However, the recovery of the first stage downrange will enhance efficiency, enabling a payload capacity of 16.5 tons to LEO. Furthermore, a planned landing back at the launch site aims to provide a substantial capacity of 11 tons to LEO. A rendered image of the rocket showcases grid fins and deployable landing legs on the first stage, highlighting the advanced design and engineering behind this project. This groundbreaking announcement comes on the heels of SpaceX's recent Starship Super Heavy launch test, underscoring the global momentum in space exploration. Despite the lack of specific details, such as a tentative test launch date and precise dimensions, the unveiling indicates that Landspace's venture is in its early stages. The development of the Zhuque-3 will undoubtedly present numerous challenges, particularly concerning the weight and properties of steel. Manufacturing and fabricating complexities will need to be navigated to ensure the success of this pioneering reusable rocket. In the competitive landscape of commercial space ventures in China, Landspace faces domestic rivals. Space Pioneer, another startup, is gearing up to launch its Tianlong 3 rocket next year, with a lifting capacity of 17 tons to LEO or 14 tons to a 500-kilometer sun-synchronous orbit. The emergence of such competitors signals a shift from the early days of commercial space companies in China, which initially focused on light-lift, solid-fueled launchers for small satellites. Beyond Landspace and Space Pioneer, several other Chinese firms, including iSpace, Galactic Energy, and Deep Blue Aerospace, are diligently working on reusable liquid propellant rockets. Many of these companies are now vying for contracts to launch batches of satellites for China's ambitious National Satellite Internet mega-constellation project, Guowang. Established in 2015, Landspace is one of China's pioneering commercial launch companies. It emerged following the Chinese government's decision to open parts of the space sector to private capital in late 2014. This development was largely seen as a response to advancements in the U.S. space industry. Notably, Landspace is on the verge of launching its third Zhuque-2 methane liquid oxygen rocket on December 4th Eastern Time. The company's initial attempt in December 2022 faced failure, but a subsequent launch in July successfully reached orbit, making Landspace the first to achieve this feat with a Methalox launcher. This accomplishment also marked the second instance of a Chinese commercial firm reaching orbit with a liquid propellant launcher following Space Pioneer's Kerolox Tianlong 2 in April. Landspace has strategically positioned itself in the industry with an intelligent manufacturing base in Huzhou, Zhejiang Province, and a substantial $1.5 billion medium and large-scale liquid rocket assembly and test plant in Jiaxing, also in Zhejiang. While Landspace leads the charge, it is not the sole Chinese player exploring the potential of stainless steel rockets. The relatively new startup, Space Epoch, conducted hot fire tests earlier this year as part of its efforts to develop a reusable stainless steel launcher. These tests involved a 4.2-meter diameter stainless steel propellant tank combined with Methalox engines developed by Juzhou Yunjian. Even China's main space contractor, the state-owned China Aerospace Science and Technology Corp. TRU, CASC, has articulated plans for a super heavy lift Long March 9, eventually envisioning it to be fully reusable. This collective push towards reusable technology signifies a pivotal moment in China's space endeavors, marking a departure from traditional approaches and embracing the future of sustainable space exploration.